one.
Well, recently in one of our weekly writing meetings, this particular room, which I'm currently lounging in, became the containment vessel for a heated debate. Now, I guess there's some topics that really push people's buttons, and this was one of them. And the topic was abortion. And our two most vocal topicers were our very own Karen and Martin.
I think when dealing with the topic such as abortion and that, and the real question behind this, this real question to this, I think, is whether the fetus is in fact a living human individual. And if so, is it no more, is it no more important to like than pulling a tooth, or is it actually a human individual?
No, Martin, I don't agree with you. I think abortion is a topic, and it's all about choice. Do women have the choice over their lives? If they don't have choice over their own bodies, how can they have control over their lives? A fetus cannot survive without a woman. If a woman is not emotionally, mentally, or financially able to support it, then why bring something into the world that she's not able to care for? Some child that may end up in an adoption agency or out in the street or in jail.
All right. I think what you have to think about too is, all right, somebody's on a life support system, all right? Mm-hmm. Somebody's on a life support system and they're only going to be there for a short time. Do you turn the life support system off because they're in it? And who also is, you know, nobody's asking the fetus what they think about this.
But someone else's life doesn't suffer as much. This is a woman we're talking about. For centuries, women have had to have abortions. They've had to have abortions and they've had to do it in back rooms and being slaughtered with coat hangers and poisoning themselves. May I finish? I haven't finished my point about death. And if we don't, abortions are going to happen whether we legalize them or not. And if we don't legalize them, women are going to continue to suffer. And until we legalize them in hospitals properly,
Karen,
women are going to have to do it in back alleys.
Listen, all right? Listen. This is not... This is not a question of free choice. It's not a question of a woman having a choice to be able to do what they want with her own body.
I think it is, Martin.
No, wait, all right? Now, will you listen to me?
Yes, I will.
All right, this is not a question about a woman being able to make a decision of their own body. Now, law states that, I mean, a person isn't allowed to commit, like, isn't allowed to attempt suicide or self-mutilation. So, I mean, law states that a person isn't actually able to do what they want with their own body. And as far as, like, mentally, there's no medical way... No medical solution. Like, abortion is not a medical solution to someone's mental problems.
Okay, but I believe
and
abortion...
Listen, all right, if you believe that the fetus is actually a child, and I can be a woman, you want to have a choice, but nobody gives the fetus a choice. Nobody gives this child inside this woman a choice.
It's arguable whether it's a child or not if it cannot survive and it's
Well, that's the question, isn't it?
But I'm really saying abortion should not be used as a contraceptive. I believe contraceptive educate people and it's a last resort, but contraceptives don't always work. And people are raped. And I think once things like rapes are stopped and we get 100% proof contraceptives, then when worst comes to worst, abortion is a last method used. I think a woman has the choice over her own body.
You're using situation ethics in order to solve a problem. Now, when a woman gets raped in a certain situation, certainly we feel bad, but is it really solving the problem? Is it really solving her mental problem and her mental state in order to have that on her
the rest of her life to have a baby that isn't even hers to deal her whole life?
Why can't she give it up for adoption?
Okay, well, I believe that the issue is as simple as it's a woman's choice over her body, and if she can't control her own body and the decisions made with it, then she has no control over her life.
So she has control as what happens to that child, too. Is that right?
Well, that's where
Who makes the decision for the child?
Well, now you know how Karen and Martin feel about it, so why don't you tell us how you feel about it? Anonymously, of course. That time of the evening to grab yourself a warm, soft body and slow down.
In the morning,
come on in.
Baby, I just can't get right. Well, I need to leave you, baby.
Probably more like, okay.